Today we are going to introduce a very important aspect of mudra. As I already said in a previous class, that mudras need to be practiced with utmost authority, with sincerity and utmost precautions, because these mudras are subtle energy rewinding phenomena where it works like a switch of electrical signals which will bring your vital energy back, which otherwise used to lose, mainly in the form of talking, seeing and electromagnetic energies in the form of hand and feet. Usually it will be lost. Mudras are a subtle energy phenomena in which we re-energize or we recapture that particular subtle energy back to our body. So one of the most commonly practiced mudras which you know already is Jnana Mudra or Chin Mudra we call. It's a mudra of knowledge or mudra of wisdom. Although there are more than 727 mudras already discovered from different scriptures like Shiva Samhita, Hatha Yoga Pradipika and mudra books, there are a few other books which have been discovered. Hatha Yoga Pradipika, they explain about 28 different mudras. So out of that 728 mudras, we are going to teach you online maybe some 20 to 30 mudras for a sincere yoga student or a teacher who is already knowing some form of yoga. Most of the Western style of yoga is a yoga of a body, physical yoga. But these are all deeper, very subtle energy channelizing techniques which usually these techniques are learnt in a presence of a guru in the form of Gurukula or a Guru Shishya Parampara, where they say Upanishad culture or Vedic culture, they say in presence of a teacher you are going to learn, and in case if you are not able to learn properly or in case there is some variation of subtle energies, Guru can identify and correct. So that's why they say it's a one-to-one technique. One teacher teaching to one disciple at one moment of time, at one point of time. So but still, because world is changing and you are going to learn these techniques online at the moment, so we have chosen some of the techniques or mudras from 30 mudras which most commonly can be practiced without much observation or guidances. But for further techniques, you need to contact whichever teacher you would like to, who either he or she in tuned themselves into spiritual practices of yoga, not just physical forms of asanas. One strange thing I'd like to quote before starting this mudra. To the Western world, the moment we say yoga, they think of asanas, different stretches and different forms of asanas. So, but in a spiritual practice, a spiritual context or depth of yoga is so much that asana constitutes less than 0.001% of total sphere of yoga. So it is that deep. See, what you are learning from external point of view is very, 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 very fraction of that particular bliss which you are going to, which you are learning in the form of asanas. They say it's just a point, less than even 0.001%. So they say asana. So what we are concentrating now is a deeper dimension of yoga. We'll start. There is an artistic depiction of a gods or goddesses in the form of holding this particular mudra and smiling gestures. You'll see different art forms of Guru Nanak, Christ or Buddha or Mahavir or any other Hindu gods you'll be seeing with this particular mudra, or which is held like this or like this. It is mainly representation of Jnana Mudra. So Jnana means wisdom or a knowledge. They say this particular mudra brings wisdom or a spiritual awareness or a knowledge out of you, they say. The thumb represents fire and the index finger represents air. So it's a very beautiful concept of combination of balancing of fire and air, and other three fingers are straight. So this is Jnana Mudra. Every day you can do this particular mudra at least for about 30 minutes to 45 minutes. There are no restriction for this kind of mudra. You can do it sitting, standing, walking, talking, chatting, anything you are doing, you can do this particular mudra. Thumb, it's a very beautiful concept. They say thumb is a divine consciousness or a cosmic consciousness or a God consciousness getting united to the individual consciousness or Jivatma. Jivatma is getting united to Paramatma. Cosmic consciousness is getting united to an individual consciousness. So it is a junction where the spiritual awareness starts. That's why they say Jnana Mudra. Other three fingers represents balanced form of Sattva, Rajas and Tamas. Three gunas. And this is a mudra. Medical point of view, if people, students with reasoning mind, I should say that thumb has a maximum representations in the brain. What I mean is, number of receptors, it's very very important concept, number of receptors in our hands are maximum compared to any part of your body, and that too, number of receptors are maximum in thumb compared to any part of your body. The receptors may be in the form of touch receptors, fine touch, coarse touch, temperature, pressure, pain, all the different kinds of receptors. So there are maximum in hands. So when there is a scientific correlation saying that there are number of receptors more in hand, and when this yogic concept says this mudra energizes or channelizes the nerve transmissions or signals, so there you feel there is some correlation, we can say. There is a bioenergy or a bioprotonic energy, or you can also say electromagnetic energy, which conserves or rechannelizes with particular forms of mudra. So that's why they say it increases wisdom, spiritual awareness, increases memory power, increases concentration, good for students. Reinforces your nerve transmission from one nerve end to other nerve end. As I already said, number of receptors are maximum in your hands. It also facilitates nerve conduction. So this can be used in students' concentration techniques and increasing memory and awareness. For spiritual benefits, we need to practice at least for about 30 minutes to 40 minutes every day, either in Sukhasana, Vajrasana or Padmasana. Any meditative posture you can sit and you can practice this particular Jnana Mudra. Jnana Mudra is also depicted as a Vayu Vardhaka Mudra. Vayu means air. Vardhana means increase. Mudra is a hand gesture. So this hand gesture increases Vayu part in your body. So this also helps in diseases which are mainly vata deficiency diseases described in Ayurveda.